piece of carpet that I took from a worn area by a door that I just repaired, and I'm gonna put this in here because it's closer to matching what I'm patching. So this is gonna take a lot of tape on the bottom side, but hopefully this will all bond and not fall to pieces. Check in shortly. Okay, all the tape has been added, and due to the fact that it's such heavy wear, added some pieces of glue stick underneath there to add extra glue to the seam when you put it together. So hopefully it'll all melt through and bond. I'm gonna start putting it together now. Alright, this one's gonna have to go together really slow. So it's probably 20 minutes doing this one. Alright, I'll check in again soon. Alright, now this side. I'm not doing this all together. I have enough irons to do it all at one time, but I kind of adjust this as you go. Alright, putting it together on this side now. That means it's melting. Getting in place good. Alright, melting the final side of it together, and then there will be reheating done when it's all done. You'll notice one iron is tilted to the side. That's because it's melting glue sticks that are underneath there. Finish with this one here. This was really difficult to try to hide because of extreme wear in the case that I did here. What I did at the end of it, back up a little bit, is basically right. Let me get something to point with. Basically right in here, it was all stuck together. So what I did was I put the irons on a towel and I steamed it. And then it allowed the fibers to stand up a little bit. One thing that you run into, if you get a little closer you can tell, but the fibers are basically all traveling this way, that way. So when you cut across the fibers, you've cut some of them in two. So you deal with a little bit of fiber loss if you get a little closer in there. And the only way to alleviate that would be to have cut from the bottom side, which is really difficult to do because you're not on the bottom side and you have to cut from the top. So that's just one of the things that you deal with when you're trying to patch together extremely worn carpet. It's not very often that you do that, but anyway, this takes a long time to do, and it's just one of the things you deal with. You know, you have to work with what you have to try to. It's broken when you get here, so you have to try to work with what you have to make something work out. And at a glance, if you don't live here and you're walking through the house, you'll never notice that there was a problem there, but I can see it because I made the repair. This is the only part that I'm not really that happy with, but made all efforts to try to make do with the situation. All right, that's the end of this repair. Corey Thibodeau, CarpetMuscle.com in Austin, Texas, 512-350-1129.